In this video, we'll run through how mass is measured and explore the differences between weight and mass. Mass is a measure of the amount of matter a body or particle contains, not to be confused with weight or relativistic mass. In day-to-day life, we talk about weight. Maybe we discuss whether someone has lost a few kilos or how many ounces of flour are in a cake. But strictly speaking, what we're really talking about is mass, not weight. In physics, it's important to know the difference. The SI unit for mass is kilograms or kg. Pounds and ounces are other common measures. A simple top-loading balance, a spring balance, and scales are some of the tools we use to measure mass in day-to-day life. More specialist purposes call for more specialized equipment. A measurement transducer measures the mass of a liquid in a calibrated tank. Scientists measuring small masses, micrograms of biological samples, would opt for a vibrating tube mass sensor. If you were a NASA astronaut in orbit at a space station, you would need a space linear acceleration mass measurement device to weigh yourself. Center of mass, or center of gravity, is the average position of the mass of an object. Mass can be uniformly distributed, like in a sphere, and in that case, the total mass can be assumed to be concentrated at its geometric center, bang in the middle. But when mass is non-uniformly distributed, the center of mass is off-center, like in this non-uniform rod. Here's a quick-fire question. Your mass is the same no matter where you are or what you are doing. True or false? According to Newton, this is true. If an object has a mass of 6 kilograms, it will still have a mass of 6 kilograms at the bottom of the ocean, at the top of Mount Everest, or even on the moon. An object's weight, on the other hand, can change depending on location. On the moon, it would weigh around a sixth of what it weighs on Earth. While mass is an intrinsic property, weight is how much force is acting on an object, measured in newtons. Weight depends on gravity. It equals mass times the acceleration due to gravity. F equals mg. On Earth, acceleration due to gravity is equal to 9.807 meters per second squared. Say an object weighs 30 newtons on the moon. The gravitational acceleration on the moon is 1.67 meters per second squared. So, what is the object's mass? If you substitute the values and solve for m, you find that the mass is 17.9 kilograms. Technically speaking, Einstein might disagree with the statement that mass is the same no matter where you are. That's because when he came up with his theory of special relativity, he introduced a measure called relativistic mass. He said that the closer you get to the speed of light, the greater your mass. So if you were on a moving spaceship, your mass would change depending on how fast you were going. The relativistic mass equation says that the mass of the moving object, m, is equal to the object's speed at rest, m0, divided by the square root of 1 minus the speed squared over the speed of light squared. To avoid confusion, some physicists prefer to call relativistic mass relativistic energy. At small velocities, the kind we encounter in everyday life, relativistic and rest mass are practically identical. We have covered how mass is measured and the difference between mass, weight, and relativistic mass. Why not try some practice questions to ensure you can confidently use these terms and calculate their value?